Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
I still hear people talking about how they feel kids are not vulnerable to this, or not particularly vulnerable, and yet the rise we're seeing, isn't that mostly from younger people?
Well, it's from younger people, mostly younger adults, but kids are getting it too. They just get a very mild disease, but then they spread it on to other people. And some kids get very sick. Don't kid yourself. So this will be great if kids 12 to 15 can get it, because already you can get it at 16. But this means that middle school and high school kids could get vaccinated. This means that indoor sports and band activities, music stuff, you know, you're not going to have all those restrictions that you have now. It really could open up school for middle and high school kids.
A story yesterday that Walgreens was having some issues canceling second appointments. Maybe you can tell people, you know, it's so hard to get these appointments to begin with. This was mostly when you booked a second appointment at a different location, or do you know?
Well, you know, that's the whole thing. We don't know.
Yeah.
It's the chaos plan. You know, the supplies are not consistent. And these pharmacies just, they can't keep up. I don't think any of the places can keep up. It's not just the pharmacies that are running out of second doses. But, you know, you have to, now you, these poor people have to scramble. That's the bad part. The good part is that as long as they get the vaccine at some particular point, it's going to work.
In this race between vaccines and variants, does this mean we're going to need a new vaccine in the future, and how far into the future?
Well, yes, we're going to need a new vaccine. The variant from the UK, B.1.1.7, has taken over Michigan. It's here in a big way in Illinois and Florida, very big. And they're getting the Brazilian variant. I mean, this is just happening everywhere. So, you know, they're going to have to tweak these vaccines. And fortunately, that's technically possible. But, you know, then it's just this whole vaccinate everybody again with the booster. And look how hard we're doing this. But I think we've got the infrastructure set up now that it's not going to be as chaotic the second time around.
Oh, that's good. Okay, let's get to some viewer questions. If you have an allergy to ibuprofen, are the vaccines safe?
Yeah, no problem. I mean, completely separate type of allergy. There's nothing in ibuprofen that's in the vaccine products.
Great.
All right, next question. My husband had a small allergic reaction, one or two hives on his face from the Moderna vaccine. Should he take Benadryl before his next dose?
Well, I don't know. This person has really two choices. Hives can be serious, and they're a sign that it could be a very severe reaction. So this person should he or she should take the vaccine in a hospital setting where there's really a lot of medical people around, because this could be a very bad reaction, or they should actually consider switching to the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
All right. This person says, my husband and I are both fully vaccinated. We are not allowing our children to play in their friends' houses or go out to eat inside a restaurant. We seem to be the only parents following these rules. Are we being too strict with them?
I think these people are like the smartest people in the city today. You know, they're playing it safe. Why not be safe? I think safe is good. You know, there is just still way too much COVID out there in the community, and the numbers are all going in the wrong direction, and we still have to be careful. And I think these parents are doing the right thing.
I think people want, they feel like this is at the tail end, though. So, you can lock everything down, say don't leave your house, but what can people do? Because I think people just hear this negative stuff, you know?
Yeah, too much negative stuff. So what's going to happen is you're going to have the vaccinated people and the unvaccinated people. And slowly what will happen as the number of people vaccinated increases, you're going to have those groups of people are going to get sort of a different set of rules than the unvaccinated people. And it's already starting with international travel. It's going to happen with domestic travel. It's going to happen on the cruise ships. It's going to happen in certain public venues where, you know, the vaccinated are going to have one privilege and the unvaccinated another. And so that will, how it will start opening up. If we ever get to herd immunity, then we're good to go.
All right. Thanks, doctor. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow at this time. Have a good day.
Thanks,
okay,
doctor.
Have a great day.
Hey, Morgan.